Cole Sillinger, who has the first of the two goals, but it's Tom Wilson. A left wing pass and a breakaway. Moving in, denied! Elvis Brzlikens coming out, makes the save.
He's got to be careful. He's going to get an interference. Uh-oh, Elvis is going crazy.
Yes, he is. He would not let the Capital player
out. Tom Wilson. They had it going all night, and Wilson ended up in the back of the net. And then Elvis Brzlikens just attacked him. It looked like he was going to get an interference call. Boy, this has turned into bedlam here. Brzlikens, no helmet on. Juracek just completely went crazy, but Wilson's here at the bench. I don't know if he's cut or what. It looked like he took a couple blocker shots to the face.
He did.
So this is going to be interesting to see what happens. He hit him with a blocker. He might be out of the game here. We'll see what happens with Elvis Brzlikens. But Tom Wilson early in this game, he ended up getting under the skin of Elvis Brzlikens. Elvis, you can see Wilson gets thrown in there. Now, Elvis comes back to get his stick. Now Wilson with that shove, and that's where Elvis just completely loses it. And Wilson couldn't really get his footing until he got up, and that's when he got that helmet off, and that's good that the referees came in. But Kuznetsov goes hard. There goes, who's that with him? Kent Johnson. And Elvis trying to get his stick. He takes a few left and rights there, but see Wilson right away there, Jeff, grabbing his face.
Yeah. He pointed to the referee that he got a couple of shots with that blocker.
Number 90, Columbus. 2 minutes roughing.
That one got away. It's a race for the puck. Coming out of his net is Dell. Dell's got Tolman, and they collide along the boards. It's still up for grabs and sent back to center. Dangerous play. Now the chase is on the other side, and a penalty call is coming up.
Yep. Dell's going to the box there. He made contact, and you can see Tolvanen goes over and has a few words for him. You don't see goalies get out that much anymore, and you certainly don't see them lay hits, and the referees are huddling up right now having a talk about it, as I think it was Tolvanen who was trying to go down the boards and avoid contact, and then Dell just laid into him, so the referee is just signaling somebody on the ice has to serve this penalty for Aaron Dell.
Buffalo goaltender assessed a minor penalty for interference.
And he didn't touch the puck. So right here, look, Tolvanen trying to avoid contact, and Dell steps into it and lays a hit there. So obvious interference call there. He's in no man's land there. So big opportunity here for the Preds. Only 24.2 left in the period.
Jersey now to the offensive blue line. Onside, the late penalty upcoming here to Columbus. Schmid makes his way out. And the crowd thinks it should be extra too many men on the ice here. And Schmid plays that puck at center. We'll wait and see.
It'll be Columbus number 44, 2 minutes for tripping. New Jersey's goalie, 2 minutes for playing the puck over the center red line.
Okay, that's what he called. You're not allowed to play it over the center red line. And play the puck on the offensive side of the red line. Here's the red line. Here's where he plays it. It also been too many men, but either way you shake it, that is a 2 minute minor.
Shooting, Jari gets a pad on it. Loose puck, it's Gabe Vilardi for Mark Scheifele. Centering, that's knocked away. Jeff Carter scoops it up. Penalty coming up here. Jets have the puck. And we got a whistle stopping play. Holding looks to be the call.
Someone on the ice
for the Penguins.
Against
Tristan Jari, yeah, so someone will have to serve it.
Pittsburgh, number 35, 2 minutes for holding.
As Jeff Carter was trying to battle that puck out of the zone, Pionk jumped on him to keep it in. Behind the play was Vilardi, who was kind of pushed in there by Pettersson, but he was trying to get away. He was really trying. He just threw the arm, put the clamp on Velarde's leg here, and he got busted. So the Jets will get a chance to get back in this game.
Point blank range. Gouley dumps one out of the air by Caulfield. Primer, oh, and then gets bumped, wanted to play it.
You got a two on one.
By Caulfield the other way. Here's Debrinkit with Larkin, and the whistle's gone at the other end.
Oh, my goodness, what is going on here? We got a penalty. We got penalties here, Larkin. We got a minute 33 to go. They just pointed at Larkin. I don't know what the heck's going on. Whoa.
May have to be a guy from the ice for Reimer, I think.
Detroit penalty number 47 minus, 2 minute minor for holding the stick.
Right. So someone from the ice has to serve it who was on the ice. Had to move the puck and never really had hold of it. But as he was trying to.
You gotta make the call.
Yeah?
Yeah, you gotta make it. You can't help it. he tried to masquerade it, but there's no way to masquerade that, especially it's Caulfield too, who's gone back on the ice and
steps in. Back door. Pitlick shoots off the side of the net, but we're gonna have a clear out.
It's gonna be a penalty. It's gonna be a penalty for knocking the net off on this play. This is a beautiful pass too, right before that by Cole Caulfield.
We've got a delay of game on the goaltender for knocking the net off.
Mike Smith argued a bit on it. He didn't think that it was something on purpose. We'll watch it here. Good movement here by the Montreal Canadiens to move this puck around, and eventually it's going to come down to Gallagher. Sorry, not Caulfield. This is a beautiful pass right through. Pitlick has a wide open shot here. But you watch what Mike Smith, when he pushes off, it's the left arm. He just kind of pushes the middle of the bar, knocks it off. Pretty hard to argue that one. He was the one that pushed it off.
The outside, short pass for Evgeny Malkin. Malkin for Zucker, got a chance. Wrister, he scores! Zucker! He gets payback, and it's 4-1!
Now, Russ is working down low, but I don't think Zucker got everything on this shot. I don't know if he was screened by his guy in front, Colby, or not.
I think he was. Krug just steps out on it, but isn't that Brian Rust hanging on to pucks, just eating it down low, guy on his back, not giving it away, and I love that above view right here. You can see how Zucker just backed out. He was right on top of the net and backed right out into that soft spot, and Rust finds Malkin, who finds Zucker in the high slot. Here we go. Bennington's not done, guys.
Yeah, he's yapping at the Penguins bench right now. That leash wasn't very long, was it?
You called it.
What is going on here?
Takes the helmet off. Look at this. Got the mullet going. This is old time. Old time hockey, Bobby.
This is old school right here.
This guy.
Somebody must have said something.
For years. He's St.
Louis. St. Louis number 50 has been assessed a 10-minute misconduct for inciting.
So Bennington gets a misconduct.
St. Louis number 50, that is, 10-minute misconduct.
Hartman able to play it in front. Zuccarello has Eriksson Ek. Got it through. They score! He found Hartman. And the Blues, Bennington coming after him. Hartman skated through Bennington's area and clipped him on the way by and celebrate.
Fleury's over there.
Come all the way down to drop the gloves.
My.
But the linesman has a hold of Bennington.
Oh, let him go. Holy jumping.
Marc-Andre Fleury trying to get at him, but the linesman won't let him. Thomas Greiss is getting ready to come into the game. This is all after a goal for the Wild and the lead back on their side.
Hartman does a great job. He strips the puck from Buchnevich, and then he gets the pass back. And now watch right there. He's celebrating, one knee in the air, and Bennington's out of his crease. Bennington goes right at him and he got a lot on him. I couldn't see that from my angle, but and there's the bump right there.
Bennington's gone back into his net here. The referees are on the headset. I wonder if they're reviewing a potential major penalty here. Couldn't really hear the announcement. They are reviewing a major penalty.
The usage of the blocker.
Which still had the stick in it, right, Panger?
Yeah.
Radko Gudas picked up, shot off the pipe by Vetrano.
That went up into the net, and what a shot that is.
Killorn, excuse me. And Jared Tenorti getting after it with Mason McTavish. It's a veteran and a young player in McTavish.
And the youngster McTavish is there, and so is Ratko Gudas. And Entwistle's got to be, you got to be careful. You got to know who you're grabbing right there. And there, yep, let's see what I mean. That wasn't going to stop. That was not going to stop. And Mackenzie Entwistle's ready for it.
And Gudas has just landed one on Mackenzie Entwistle, who's trying to protect himself. And Peter Mrazek stepping in to try and break things up with Gudas.
And
my
here
goodness.
Comes Gibson. Let's see what we got here. Let's see what we got.
Reese Johnson battling Pavel Minyakov right now. And Gibson is trying to grab at Mrazek.
Body's on the ice down there. You got to be careful of the skate blades right there. Minyakov, man, did he throw a roundhouse right? That was a surprising one there. Gibson wants to grab the goalie. He's telling the referee, let's go. Well, Mrazek was coming in, and I said that about Entwistle. When you got, you're there with Ratko Gudas, Entwistle's gloves weren't off. So now he gets up on it. He doesn't have the mitts off, so he has no way to grab Gudas. Gudas has got a hold of him, and that's where Mrazek tried to come in there and defend Entwistle. Now from the wave to the roars to the excitement of a scrap to the goalies coming in.
The penalty box looks like the Anaheim bench right now.
And Mrazek still having words over there with Gibson. That's exhausting. Behind the net here, he comes over to Norty. Zaitsev comes in right there. Now we got the pile. Now when Gudas comes in here and Entwistle grabs him, you can see Gudas says, this guy's low center of gravity is going to take you down. And all of a sudden he starts throwing to rights. And Entwistle's mitts aren't off right there. So that's where Mrazek saw something that he didn't look like it was going to end up well. And then now with the camera right here on Gibson, you've got he can't get the glove off because it's strapped in right there. Got it. Oh, get it off. No, we got it off with relative ease right there. Most of them got a strap that's tight on the wrist, and he jumps in there because Mrazek had jumped in there. There's Ratko Gudas on the left, and Gibson's got the mask right there. Just hauls the mask off of Mrazek, just yanked it right off his melon. And Lucas Dostal's coming into the hockey game. Mrazek gets to stay. Gibson came all the way from his end, all the way to initiate that. I don't know what Mrazek gets. He's got to get something for leaving the crease.